Another one bites the dust. Yes, sir. No, Amy Ford, you would have remembered her. She was one of those persons that spoke during the Republican National Convention. No, she has been arrested. Here's some of what she said during the convention.
Ford, I've been a registered nurse for 17 years. I'm from the small town of Williamson, West Virginia, where I've lived my entire life, the daughter of a nurse and a coal miner. Even though I was the youngest of four children, I was always somewhat of a caretaker. It came natural for me. So it felt right to follow in my mother's footsteps and become a nurse. And this March, when COVID-19 sent our country into crisis, I knew I had to help any way that I could. I deployed to New York in April and then to San Antonio, Texas, working as a COVID relief nurse in both states. As I contended with the challenges of treating our patients who had their worlds turned upside down, I noticed a positive change in our healthcare system. President Trump recognized the threat this virus presented for all Americans early on and made rapid policy changes. And as a result, telehealth services are now accessible to more than 71 million Americans, including 35 million children. Prior to COVID, telehealth was not covered or reimbursed under Medicare, Medicaid, or CHIP. This left our most vulnerable populations with no other choice but to have an in-person office visit with their physicians, increasing their risk of exposure to COVID-19 exponentially. The expansion of telehealth services has also resulted in the integration of video visits between patients and their families, allowing loved ones to have contact and visualization, as well as a better understanding of care. Telehealth has been essential during this pandemic. I don't want the media taking my personal story and twisting it, so let me be clear. As a healthcare professional, I can tell you without hesitation, Donald Trump's quick action and leadership saved thousands of lives during COVID-19. And the benefits of that response extend far beyond coronavirus. Telehealth will continue to aid many that are just unable to find transportation or a way to the doctor for regular checkups. This is especially true in rural America. I live in a town of about 2,000 people. We do not have buses, trains, trolleys, or Ubers available to us. In addition, the unavailability of services can also hinder treatment for many. So increased access to telehealth for millions of Americans.
Ford was arrested on Saturday after shooting a woman in her stomach in her hometown of West Virginia. She was charged with malicious and unlawful assault. The woman's name is John DeWitt, who she survived the shooting. No, they had arrested Ford, who later posted bond and is now out of jail. Ford is just one of the persons that are associated with the Trump circle or have a little association with him that has either found themselves in trouble or went to prison. Now, recently, really of a fact, the Trump circle has been cursed. Anything that has been tied to Trump has been cursed. The people have either contracted COVID, they will die, such as in the case of John McCain. They have died, such as in the case of Herman Cain. They go to prison or they end up in jail or do something that will put them in an awkward place. Is the president cursed? What do you think? What are your thoughts? Because certainly those that come against in his path, there's something automatically happens. What are your thoughts? Please let me know by leaving them in the comment section below. Kindly like, share. If you haven't subscribed to this channel as yet, please do so. Thank you very much. Be safe.
Thank you for watching. Like the video before you go. Please subscribe if you haven't done so. And remember to share the video with your friends and family. And browse the channel for more quality content. Until next time, walk good, my friends.